We were lucky to get Detective Lewis. He's busy man. Busy, busy man. He's organising some things. So, yeah. Oh, choking. Can't choke during an interview. It's rude. Oh my gosh. Okay. No, here we go. Hi everyone, I am Christy Grace and I am the author behind the incredible story Kidnapped Entanglement. But it's not just my story, it includes the amazing and brave and pretty intense adventures of four really special people, and I'm going to go through and interview them all today. Detective Lewis, Tony, if I may, it is very nice to have you here to finally talk about this book that has come out, Kidnapped Entanglement, about the story of you and your daughter.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate you interviewing me about this very intense ordeal.
How do you feel when you see the story in a book format that the world can read?
Having the book out is interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I think that we can all learn something from the experience that happened, and it's important to know how to look after yourself.
Well, your car got shot at pretty good in the whole scheme of this adventure. Did you manage to get that fixed?
I find it interesting that that's your first question, but yes, we did. We got the car fixed. We removed the bullet holes, and yes, it took a while in the shop, but eventually all the damage came out. Car's back to normal. Ship shape.
One of the moments we saw was you at the beach house with Aaron Campbell. Have you ever considered buying your own beach house, particularly after seeing his?
My wife and I have wanted a beach house for quite some time, but as I mentioned to Aaron at the time, Mr. Campbell, we can't afford it, but we like to rent. That way we get to see different parts of beach areas, which is nice. It's good. It's solid to be able to know more about different areas. Take all that in. We'd like one day if we could afford it, but you know, we like the beach. We're beach people.
So what made you partner with Mr. Campbell in the first place?
Mr. Campbell and I had similar things in common. We had loved ones who were going through the same situation, and back at the police station when we were questioning him initially, I was pretty certain that he was holding something back, and as it turned out, he was. I went to his house mainly to ask him about what it was that he was holding back, and in the end found out something that he wasn't going to tell the police and that we felt was important to figure out ourselves until we worked out all of the finer details. And so yes, we joined together to get things done and save our family. Save my daughter and his wife.
What was it like being in contact with your old military commando unit?
We've been in contact for quite some time, my old unit and I. We're always there for the big important things, as I believe is mentioned in the book, and that is accurate. We keep in contact for those things, the big stuff. But unfortunately, with most of them still actually active, I haven't been able to be in as close contact as I would have liked. But it was very nice to work with them again, and very proud of them, proud of what we did together, and we managed to work together pretty well, and it was really good to see them. You end up like family, so they are still family, as far as I'm concerned.
Before I ask you a last burning question, what would you say to people if they were interested to hear more about Kidnapped Entanglement, this whole story?
My name is Tony Lewis, and if you're interested to see about Kidnapped Entanglement and the ordeal that me and my family went through, you can read the book at ChristyGraceScarletPen.com. It's up to you. Get the facts right.
Well, our final question that we have for you is a pretty important one. It's one that has been burning on most of our minds, as a matter of fact. Why exactly did you leave the military?
That's something that I don't talk about, and I don't think it's appropriate of you to ask that question. As far as I'm concerned, this interview is over. Thank you very much.
Detective, please. Detective, but we haven't finished.
Must have been something pretty saucy over there. For him to get up like that in the middle of an interview, my gosh. Wonder if there was some sort of conspiracy.
Hey, are you still recording? We hope you enjoy the interviews with our main characters from Kidnapped Entanglement. It was a pretty amazing story, and there were some pretty cool things that went down. I am privileged to have been the author to tell their very, very exciting story. Thank you so much for watching these interviews. We'll see you next time.